In this video, we will introduce you to the specifics of distributed ledger technology systems and walk you through the process of their testing. DLT platforms such as Corda, an open-source solution developed by R3, enable businesses to transact directly and in strict privacy using smart contracts, cutting out the middleman, reducing transaction and record-keeping costs, and streamlining business processes. DLT technology is relatively new in the financial industry space, but it's evolving quickly. The projects tend to be driven by two main factors: taking POC software into production and ensuring that platforms meet the existing regulatory standards. Compared to traditional systems, DLT platforms pose some additional challenges in terms of quality assurance. These stem from the necessity to verify the interoperability of nodes in the network, the existence of a large number of connection permutations between them, as well as the need to understand the differences between varying permissioning logic. For testing, this leads to hundreds of millions of tests, a problem only solved by automation. In this video, we will demonstrate a test automation approach to the functional testing of distributed ledger technology platforms. Let's have a look at the main DLT platform components. A DLT platform is essentially a network of nodes. Nodes stand for transaction participants. Each node in Corda is a JVM runtime environment with a unique identity on the network. A Corda network is made up of many such nodes that want to transact with each other in order to maintain and evolve a set of shared facts. This network is permissioned, which means nodes need to acquire an X509 certificate from the network operator in order to join the network. Each node maintains a public and a private key, where the private key is used to attest to facts by signing the associated data, and the public key is used by other nodes to verify these signatures. The shared facts between nodes are represented by states. States are immutable. When modified, the current state is marked as historic and is replaced by a new state. This creates a chain of states that gives us a full view of the evolution of shared fact over time. This evolution is done by a Corda transaction. Transactions can also contain commands which indicate the transaction's intent in terms of how the state's data are used. Each command is also associated with a list of public keys that need to sign the transaction for it to be valid. There's a common problem when someone tries spending a specific cash state to two different parties. This is known as double spend and is prevented in Corda via the concept of notaries. A notary is a Corda service that's responsible for attesting that a specific state has not been spent more than once. This process is known as transaction finalization in Corda. Corda applications are called Corda apps. They contain several components, of which the most important ones are the states, their contracts, and the flows. The flows define the workflows between the nodes used to perform an update to the ledger or simply exchange some messages. All the ledger states relevant to a node are stored in its database. This part of the database is called the vault. A node provides some more APIs that can be used for various purposes, such as starting flows or querying the node's vault. These can be accessed remotely via a client, which provides a remote procedure call or RPC interface that's implemented on top of the existing messaging infrastructure. Exactpro's test automation framework for DLT is based on the company's core tool, ClearDH. ClearDH is able to simulate the following node functions on the Corda ledger: nodes deployment with an ability to change the configuration, Corda apps deployment, nodes administration, nodes registration in the network, triggering transactions generation, verification, and distribution across the nodes, JVM statistics gathering, log monitoring and analysis, database verification and monitoring. In this video, we have demonstrated Exactpro's original test automation approach for testing Corda. As the number of DLT implementations across all industries increases, DLT-based infrastructures get more and more complex and varied in their architecture. They can be extremely heterogeneous. It may be possible to deploy different versions of an application on different security devices, different databases, different Java machines, and operating systems. This creates a combinatorial explosion when one tries to test them. In its adaptation for DLT architectures, CleaGH is network agnostic and can be applied to any blockchain. If you would like to learn more about Exactpro's DLT testing approach, follow the link to our DLT testing case study discussing the specifics of the new techniques for the functional testing of distributed ledger technology.